Okay, let's see what's happening with our profits then. So we made 60 million, 66 last year. So that's good. How's our line profitability doing? So Halo Freight 1's losing 4 million. Halo Freight 2 is losing 3 million currently. All right. We need more freight on the line. Although it is starting to pick up now. Let's check our profitability. Our productivity. Is our productivity going up? Didcot Farm is going up. Oh man, we've got our first jet, the de Havilland Comet. Oh, hell yes. We do need to upgrade our trains. We really, really need to upgrade our passenger trains at this point. This is the only thing with running it on fast. Let's slow it down. All right. So, yeah, production's pretty good. What we need to do is now expand that by adding in additional product chains around the place. So, building materials. Let's do another building materials, because we've only got one building materials going on, which is... let's turn the icons back on so we can see what the hell's going on. So, let's turn all this rubbish back on. We'll turn those off. Right, so we've got building materials going on over here. What ideally we want is another building materials somewhere over this side. Now, the stone there... God, is that really the closest stone? I think it might be. Holy hell. So we'd have to get it over to, like, that one, I suppose. Alright, well, let's do it then. So... Alright, how the hell are we going to do this? Well, we're going to put in a freight station. Let's pause this while I do this. We want one platform. We'll extend the length, I suppose. So you need to be pointing at that quarry over there, don't you? God, it's quite a long way to ship stuff, isn't it? All right. No, I'm going to save the high speed. The high speed is just going to be for the passenger stuff, I think. I think this is going to be... Oh, 75 mile an hour. It's not that freaking fast, is it? All right, well, now we'll do it. Because you got some moan otherwise. I know you will. I'll get comments. Why didn't you put the high-speed train in this guy? You know you would. Right, where are we going to put you? I don't know. Somewhere over here, maybe. Like there, maybe. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do. Right, let's hook that up with a... Yeah, medium country road will do. There we go. Terrain alignment. All right. There. Thank you. Okay, so we've got that station in. Now we need to put the other end in. Where the hell am I going? Can you even see where I'm going? I'm going to that one over there, aren't I? Yeah, okay. All right, so... Yeah, well, we're going to head over that way because we've got to go around that oil refinery. Okay, so we'll put you in there. And then we'll put in a train track. Am I going to double track this? Answer, probably. In fact, I would say almost definitely. Right. 13 million for that. Because it's a big and a deep tunnel. Oh, 13 million. Yep, take it. Because I love doing stuff like that. Right, then we want to double track it. So, I don't know, from about, I don't know, like there maybe. And all the way out to, well, we're going to have to do it to like there, aren't we? There we go. Okay, so that's that. And then we just want a depot, don't we? Yeah. So, I put in high-speed tracks, didn't I? But I didn't... Did I put in high-speed tracks? I can't remember now. No, I put in standard tracks. Yep, I put in standard tracks. Hang on, I thought I was putting in high-speed tracks. Oh, no, I did at the station. Ah, okay, I need to upgrade the tracks. Okay, my bad. My bad, okay? My bad. So, high-speed tracks. Fortunately, it does it in fairly big sections, so it's not like a big deal to upgrade. There we go, and last little bit there, and there. Cool. Okay, we've got high-speed tracks. Right, let's put in a high-speed depot. And that looks good. Yep, yep. And we'll put in a little switch. There we go. And on the other side. Let's try that again. So, there we go. Alrighty, cool. So all I need to do now is put in a line. So let's put in a new line. That'll do. And we're going from whatever that station is to whatever that station is. Yorkie Pud to Ice Cream Town. Is anybody feeling hungry? Right, so having done that, I do need to do a little bit of signalling here. And there should be a signal there. And there should be a signal over there. There we go. Cool. Right, that's all of our signalling done. Right, let's get some frickin' trains on here. Now, what are we hauling? We're hauling stone, aren't we? I extended these, didn't I? I think. Yeah, to 240s, I think they were. Yeah, 240s, yeah. Okay, so we can get a decent amount of trucks on there. And we can always extend them. These are pretty easy to extend if we wanted to. So, what are we going to buy? Oh, well, let's see, because we've got some new stuff. That's electric. What the hell is this? It's diesel hydrogen. 56 miles an hour. Massive pulling power. Well, actually not that massive. That's a nice diesel loco. That does 75 miles an hour as well. Which I still could have put standard tracks in though. Is that like the fastest? Now, we could put mallards on. Yeah, pulling power, 90 miles an hour. I've got to say, I'm kind of tempted. Should we put a couple of mallards on there just for fun? How much is this thing? This is only like 3.6 million. What are the running costs? 600,000 a year. This is, that's only 850. Ah, it's great. Let's put some mallards on. Bye. And this is a prestige train, and we've got it hauling stone. Oh, the train driver's going to be so disappointed. Be like, hey, you're going to be driving a mallard. Oh man, which line am I going to be running? Am I going to be on the Halo line? No, you're hauling stone. So shut up, get on with it. Right, we're hauling stone. So we want open wagons, which we haven't got the upgrade for, and their top speed 75 mile an hour. Oh man. I was hoping for the 99. Well, there's no point then. There's no point putting a mallard on. Oh, man. All right, well, we'll stick Flying Scotsman on then. All right, so buy Flying Scotsman. And then how many trucks do we want? Oh, I was getting all excited then. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, I don't know, 14. It'll handle 14 easy. All right, let's do that. And then we want to clone it. Don't we? Yeah, we do. Clone it and then put them both on line 2. Cha-ching, go. Oh, I thought we were going to see a new train then. We haven't seen anything new yet. You know what? We can upgrade our DC-4s with Comets. How about that? How would that be? So, there we go. So, you're going to troll out and troll up and down here. That's fine. So, that's going to haul the stone in. But, that's only half the story. Pause. Because we need to get the stone, the building materials from here to this station. Now, that's kind of sort of easier said than done. Yeah, that's in the catchment area. Okay, we'll put that in there. Yeah, okay, fine. So if we go out like that and notch it down a bit like that. How far across can we go? Okay, we can go across, I don't know, probably something like that. All right, so we want to bring it. Where are we going to? I can't even see the freaking station now because that thing's in the way. Oh, there's the end of the station. All right, so we want to come out to, I don't know, maybe there. Now that's above ground. Oh, that should work, surely. Well, that's as high as it'll go. Okay, well, let's try that. And then pop you in. Ah, there we go. Cha-ching. Awesome. Right, are we going to want to double track that? We are eventually, but I'm going to just going to run it single for now, I think. We want a depot. Let's put a throw in a quick depot. There, and... there. Yep, that's good. That's good. Okay, we put in a new line from there to there. Oh, nice lilac colour. Isn't that pretty? Then what do I want to do? I want to buy a train. Now, this is hauling building materials, isn't it? Yes, it is. I haven't made this high-speed train because high-speed tracks, it actually doesn't freaking matter because we're going to be using Flying Scotsman by with building material. Now, building materials, here we go, construction materials. They're in these. Ah, see, now this could have been high-speed. Man. Ah, right. Yeah, we're putting in a mallard. Finally, we get to see a freaking mallard. All right. Buy that, and then we want, I don't know, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm thinking like about 8. Yeah, that should be fine. Yeah. It's coming downhill with a heavy load. It could probably handle 10, to be honest. Yeah, what the hell? What the hell? We've got 2 trains whizzing backwards and forwards. But it's double the length. Nah, you know what? We'll put that in for now and then we'll upgrade later. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so you need to go on line lilac. There we go. All right, go. Cool. So we've got building materials going on. Let's have a look at our airports, shall we? Yes. So we have got 1 passenger on there and no passengers on the other 2. Are you freaking kidding me? And 2 of our planes have gone missing. Apparently I didn't put in the other 2. Man. Okay, well. These are the DC... Oh, no, I was going to say those are the DC... No, it's Ice Cream Winston are the DC-4s, aren't they? Yeah, those are the DC-4s. All right, well, let's go over here. Let's at least see something new, shall we? So, buy aircraft. Oh, De Havilland Comet. The first... proper commercial jetliner. And they only cost 1 million. Oh no, that's that one. How much do these cost? 5.6 million. Yeah, that's more like it. Alright, cool. 20 passengers, 450 miles an hour. Wow. Alright, well, the first thing we want to do is sell off the DC-4s. So where's our DC-4s? Here's our DC-4s. So let's sell those off. Return to depot and be sold. Cool. And then now let's see. It's not we've hit 1960. I'm just gonna double check and see. Can we upgrade to 2 runways yet? Nope. Oh. No, it's 1. It'll show up in here if you've got the 2 runway one, which is the large airport. Okay, well, never mind. What the hell was I doing? I was gonna buy some comets, wasn't I? Buy De Havilland Comet. We'll buy 2 of those beauties. Actually, yeah, no, we'll have 2. Yeah, what the hell? We'll have 2. We'll put those on the Winston Ice Cream run. And then we'll head over to... Really, I should be putting this in our premium slot from Barrington to Winston. Yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there eventually. Oh, what the hell was I doing? Oh, yeah, I was going to buy 2 more. Yeah, so let's buy 2 more. 1, 2. Actually, I can leave this running while I'm doing this. And then, yeah, you can go on there. Okay. Right, let's go and have a look at a De Havilland Comet. Here we go. proper aeroplanes. It was a very cool looking aeroplane, wasn't it? With the long engines close to the body. Let's pop you up there. So you're gonna pop into the terminal and see if you can pick up some passengers, which you can't because there aren't any freaking passengers for some reason. All the passengers have decided that they're just not interested anymore. God only knows why. We had about, how many did we had about like, I don't know, 20 or 30 passengers on one of the lines at one point, and then they all just gave up. Okay, how long are you going to sit there before you take off? Oh, here we go. Actually, you know, pause for, oh, the other one's going first. Okay, I tell you what, this one, details, colour. I'm going to change the colour on this. That's a bit nicer. A little bit nicer. What does it look like in red? Yeah, a bit garish. I think blue's better. Yeah, we'll go for the blue. Cool. Okay, you know what? We'll start naming some aircraft. Let's see. Okay, Renosian wanted a plane called, let's whiz this back, Never Say Oops. So there you go. There you go. That's this plane. And that's the one we're going to watch take off, I think. Yeah, so let's get out there and pop that up there. And follow and go. So we're going to follow the takeoff of the Never Say Oops. I am going to name some other planes as well before the end of this episode. And let's see, I've done Freeze's airport. I need to do RAF Halton, and I need to put something in for Samuel Logan, who again has become a patron, just so he can have his name in the game. So, Sam, we'll get you in. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. That's freaking awesome. I'm sensing a screenshot. I love it when the engines are throttled back. Okay, that's enough of that. Now, I've let the game run on just a little bit. We're up to September 1961. I haven't run it on very much, but I just want to take a look and see, are we shipping any of this stone out now? Let's have a look. How are we doing? What is your production? Oh, his production's up to 82. Nice. So, yeah, he's starting to churn the stone out, so that's good. Where are our trains? Here's our train, so you take it some, that's the other one. Yeah, here he comes, bringing some stone in. How are you doing? Your production's 60. I'm guessing you're short. Yeah, he hasn't got any stone at the moment. He's kind of desperate for this guy to bring in some stone. Product potential is high. That's good. Here we go. How much stone are you bringing? 14? Is that all? Okay, well, I guess it's still early days. Ooh, 300k, that's nice. Right, so now he's got some stone, which is stacking up over there. Lovely. He's going to process that, and then that'll go out here. Oh, how much did you just pick up? Oh, you just picked up 12, so. Yeah, once this ramps up, which obviously it's going to do, what are you up to now? 86, come on, get going. Potential 93, good. Yeah, he's ramping up, definitely. Good. So that's going to mean that we'll start seeing production materials appearing at this, which means that our trains that come round here, now where's the, oh, here we go, here's the next freight train. Oh, no, that's the Combat 601. Where's the next freight train? Here he is. So I'm guessing that you've got no building materials, have you? Nope, he's got no building materials at all. He's got a bunch of fuel, but no building materials. So obviously those carriages are empty, all right, when they could be carrying stuff. So now, from now on, when they come round to here, they're going to be able to stock up with more building materials and ship them out. Okay, so let's have a look. A town like Confusedford, I'm guessing it's got probably very little in the way of... one building material. That's all he's got. Whereas if we go over to the other side of the line, like somewhere like Viewterville, which is just after the brickworks, we'll probably find that he's got a fair amount. Oh, no, he's only got two. How can he only have two? Like, seriously, and oh my lord... Okay, it's producing a lot of freaking food, that's for sure. Now, yeah, you're carrying a full load of food. And... Oh, you're not, because you're full of other stuff. You're full of machines and tools. Wow, and then the next train's already turning up. And he's carrying... Oh, no, that's the train that's bringing the food in. So, yeah. Ooh, he's full of machines and tools. Wow. Man, we need more freaking freight trains. What about you? What are you? Are you full of... Yeah, he's got 43 fuel. Oh, he's only got two machines. Oh, we've got a new carriage available. Sweet. All right. So, let's just a quick recap on our lines. So, how are we doing? Let's get back up the top. So, Halo Freight 1 and 2 are still losing a bit of money, but not as maybe as much as they were. Let's have a look at Halo Freight 1 finances. Oh, yeah. Yep. We're definitely getting closer to making a bit of a profit. So, that's good news. When we get these bricks on here, that'll help a bit more. Let's have a look at... Have a look at one of our GP lines and just see if it's getting any better. So I don't know, like, where would be a good one to look at? I'm thinking, yeah, not Landsberg necessarily. I'm thinking somewhere like maybe Sparksville. Yeah, no, that's Winston. No, let's have a look at this one. So, how are your finances? Oh, you were getting there, and now you've dropped off. I wonder why that is. Oh, now I wonder if that's the point at where we've upgraded the vehicles and now we've got too much carrying capacity. That is very, very possible, you know. It may be that we've just got too many damn trucks on these lines for the amount of stuff that we've got to haul. I'm thinking that's definitely the case. Let me know what you think. Should I just cut back on some of these vehicles, maybe? I mean, it's not like we can't afford it. I mean, we can afford it. And maybe I should be focusing more on getting more freight trains on the line. Because we have got room for more freight trains. Definitely. See, look, this station is empty. And where's the next freight train? Is this the next freight train coming in now? No, that's the Skystormer. The next freight train is there, train 43. And there, I think, yeah, that's another passenger train. So, yeah, there isn't another freight train in sight. Yeah, the next freight train is back here. Train 45. So, yeah, I think more freight trains and keep adding more of these sites, putting more stuff onto the lines. I think that is the solution. I have one last look at this. Okay. Production's 80. Details. Oh, look. The potential's going up. Oh, the Zaphod Express has reached its lifetime and should be replaced. And Toby the Tank Engine as well. Okay, well, based on the fact that our passenger trains are starting to reach the end of their life, I think it's time to unleash the Mallard. Unleash the Kraken. Right. But before I do that, I wanted to show you this. Look. We've got a freight train just pulling in to Honkel Briff Industries over here. And I just wanted to show you, right, so fuel, 0 of 60. And how much have we got waiting? Okay, we've got about 150 on each. Now, the thing is, this train is too long for this station. So I was wondering, like, would these last two cars get used or whatever? So I just thought we'd have a little look. And hopefully you will see that this picks up a full load of fuel. Yes, it does. Boom, 90 fuel. Excellent. Alrighty, so there you go. Now, I will pick up on some comments. Several people have left me comments and said, oh, you should have a dedicated, you should dedicate your train so that they've got all oil tankers or all state cars or whatever. Yeah, I don't really see the point in doing that. If you've got 10 trains on the line, right, then it doesn't matter whether they're dedicated to be like three of them are all fuel and three of them are all state cars and or whether they're split up. The thing is, if they're split up, you've got a better chance, say we've got more trains reaching the end of their life. Now's a good time to upgrade to the Mallard, I think. If they're split up, then you've got like more chance of picking up like full loads on those cars when you go through each station. So that's the kind of the idea behind it. Here we go. And that picks up another full load. Cool. Yeah, we're getting through this. We are getting through this now. These trains are kind of rocking and rolling. I really want the upgrade for the boxcar. We haven't got that yet. Right, let's pause this for a second. And somebody actually left me a comment and said, the reason you're having so many problems is because you keep pausing the game. Really? That did make me smile, I have to say. Right, what are we going to do next? What are we going to do next? Oh, yeah. I was just reading through the comments. My God, there's a lot of people waiting over there. How many people have we got waiting there? Jeez. Okay, yeah, we do need to upgrade. We've got a lot of people waiting at Bickerty's Hollow. In fact, we've got a lot of passengers waiting everywhere now. You know what? I went round and checked this not that long ago, and the queues weren't that long, and now they really freaking are. And look at the food we're producing. Okay, things are starting to rock and roll, you know. It could be interesting to see how our profits go. What the hell was that? Oh, yeah, the planks line. Apparently, one of the trains on the planks line, it has got the wrong cars. Now I'm looking at it, I think I'm actually starting to remember that I put the wrong... that's the iron one. Where's the... It's on the planks line. So that's one. Now that's got the state cars, which is right, isn't it? Yep. Yeah, planks. Yeah, that's carrying planks. But the other train that's on this line apparently is doing nothing. But well, where is it then? There is only one train on that line, isn't there? Let's have a look. Belper planks. Vehicles. Is it... what are you talking about, guys? There's only one train on the planks line. Now, hang on. What about the bottom half? Now, maybe this is the one that I got wrong. It's eminently possible. So this has got state cars. That's fine. So it's carrying steel and planks. What about? Well, where's the other one then? Oh, that's this one. No, that's carrying steel and planks. What are you guys talking about? Like, seriously, what the hell are you talking about? There's only one train on this line, and it's the right one. That's the iron ore train that's bringing in ore from the iron mine. Okay, right. Total digression. And like, what the hell are you guys smoking? What we're gonna do? Let's bring up the line manager, and we'll get rid of these four. So, yeah, we'll sell those. Right, cool. And then we'll send a couple of these onto the Barrington Ice Cream line. So that one and that one go to Barrington Ice Cream. Okay, cool. All right, so now we've got two planes flying on each, which, if nothing else, will at least reduce our losses until we can figure out what the hell is wrong with the airplanes, because I honestly don't know what the hell is wrong with the airplanes. Maybe the distance isn't far enough or whatever. I don't know. I think when we do the second series, and I am going to do a second series, which is going to be on the American map, I think we'll change the aspect ratio. This is a square map, but you can also have them... So this is 1x1, right? You can also have it 1x2 or 1x3, right? So I think maybe we'll do... I don't know, maybe a long thin map. Maybe a 1x2 might be kind of fun. 1x3 might be a bit too thin. But I don't know, we'll see. Right, let's... I've got it running on medium as well. Oh. Right, quick, but I better pause it for a while. Oh no, everything's going to break. Let's do some mallards, shall we? Yeah, go on, let's do some mallards. So, replacement. Set vehicle. This is going to be Class A4, the mallard. Now, is that still the fast? I think that's still the fastest train that we've got. So look, you're 56, 78, you're 75, 56, 87. No, that's it. We do have these though, which are sweet. Top speed of 87. Right, so yeah, that's gonna be the best thing to go with our mallard. All right, cool. So let's have a mallard plus. Now these are longer than these, so I'm thinking, and let's see, they're 21. And they're 20. Really? Well, in that case, I'm still going to go with 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1.2 million these damn things are. Holy crap. Okay, so yeah, we'll go with those. Oh, it's all nice and blue. Those are going to look freaking nice, aren't they? All right, yes, we want to upgrade that. 9. 10. Okay, and 25%, and yes. Have you any freaking idea how much this is going to cost? 17 million per vehicle. Wow. All right. Let's see this happen. Now, which train are we going to have a look at? And we could look at any of them. We could look at, well, I suppose, probably the Flying Cock. Don't you think? So, here we go. You know, I should have been kind of updating the name of the Flying Cock, because this is like the third Flying Cock. It never got upgraded to a Scotsman. Oh, there we go. That's what we've been waiting for. The Mallard. Oh my god, that is pretty sleek and sexy, isn't it? Now let's have a look. We'll carry on following it. It's picked up a full load of 210 passengers. It's way too long for the for the station. We've actually got scenery around the place. Good lord. You know what? Should I get rid of this so that we can actually see this damn thing properly? They're not quite all upgraded yet. Let's move that over there for a bit. And get rid of that one so that we don't have the lines. So we can actually enjoy it properly. Let's get that right out of the way. Oh my God, look at that. Three trains all together. Our lines are packed. My God, there's a lot of smoke produced by these. And of course, now it goes into a freaking tunnel. All right, let's have a bit of first person through the tunnel. Look at these places. These places are really starting to look good now, aren't they? I am definitely going to do a video where we go round like the whole circuit, because people have been asking for that. So we will do that. Oh, look, there's a plane over there. Yeah, the place is really looking nice, isn't it? We've got a great big building there. Look at all this, my God, I mean... Now, like, if you compare this to City Skylines, right? Now, you could obviously build all of this in City Skylines, but... Oh my God, you'd have to kind of do it all yourself. Whereas this, like, all of that is done for you, and you can just have the fun of playing with the trains. But, you know what, let me pause it for a second, because let's say over here, it's a little bit bare over here. And, I don't know. You know, in fact, let's pick somewhere else. Let's pick, I don't know, maybe over here. Let's say you wanted to create the illusion of maybe like stockyards or something. Let's say you had a farm nearby and you wanted some stockyards. Well, you go into here and let's see. We want, yeah, I think it's the next one. Oh, no, it is this one. Wooden fences. Look. Yeah, little wooden fences. So, I'm going to flip that round and you could put in... Put in a bunch of nice wooden fences, and make a bunch of like stockyards or like whatever you wanted to do. Put you there, and then you there. There we go. You could do stuff like that. Come on, it's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool. We could put some rocks in, and then slap some trees around it. And suddenly the place looks a little bit more interesting. I think that's very cool, personally. Might be doing a bit more of that going forward. So yeah, I think we've had a fairly good look at the Mallard, haven't we? You want a bit more? Alright then, we'll have a bit more. We'll have a bit more Mallard time. Since we've been waiting so long for it. I tell you what we can look at. I'm going to change this. This is going to be the Flying Cock 3. There we go. Right, so what speeds are we getting up to is the interesting thing. 36, 37, 38. Oh, we need more bridges and stuff around the place. That's for damn sure. More bridges, more tunnels. The Mallard is a beautiful train. God, I remember having a train set, like a proper train set, as a kid. And you used to put little drops of oil into the locomotive and it used to actually produce smoke as it went round. That was like just the best freaking thing in the world, seeing that tootling around with smoke coming out of it. We are getting a bit of lag now and again, but to be honest, now some people have like complained about it and they've said, oh, you know, it's kind of off-putting in whatever. The thing is, what I like about this game is that they haven't, like, when they've been playtesting this, which obviously they will have because they always do. Like, I'm talking about every developer. When they, well, not every developer. I mean, obviously, not EA, but. So, like, when they've playtested this, instead of going, oh, you know what, guys? It gets a bit laggy. Ooh, we need to cut down the size of the maps. Let's only give them, like, instead of giving them this really, really huge map, let's only give them the medium map. Right, which is what some developers would absolutely do. They've gone, nah, screw it. Right, you know, maybe they've got like a absolutely massive computer that can actually handle it. Or maybe they'll say, maybe they don't care that it's a bit laggy sometimes and the frame rate isn't like maxed out all the time. Good, I like that because I don't mind the odd bit of lag. And I don't mind that I'm not getting 60 frames per second all the time. Look at this. VW Beetle. There's a nice mix of cars around now. Yeah, let's make sure that all of these have upgraded now, which I'm guessing. Look at this. We had 500 million. We've now got 86. Good Lord. We just spent 460 million on new vehicles. Are you kidding? Oh my God. Wow. But the incredible thing is that last year we made 110 million. Wow. Now, where the hell did all that come from? Let's have a look at our lines. Where's Halo Freight 1? Where's Halo Freight 1? Don't tell me Halo Freight 1's making a profit. Where is it? Let's change the names. Sort it by name, rather. Where's Halo Freight 1? Halo Freight 1? Oh my God! Halo Freight 1 is only losing 500,000. No, that's 1,000,000. But man, are they starting to get profitable? Because I'm actually putting some stuff on the lines. You know, I swear to God, guys, if we get more stuff on the lines, we'll start making money. Now, if they're carrying more stuff, then we should be seeing our GP lines getting potentially a bit more profitable. There's still some of them losing a hell of a lot. I mean, Dawlish. That's kind of understandable, because... Oh, there's more of these turning green though. Confused for GP is making a profit. Oh my Lord. Premier 2 Caton GP is making a profit. Rootborough GP is making a profit. Oh, hell yes. You're still losing 150k. Beautiful GP is making a nice profit. 110k. Winniston's still losing out. Alrighty, but we're getting there. So I'm going to be interested to see what we make this year. Oh my Lord. Okay, before I forget, because you know what I'm like. Before I forget, let's just go down here and we'll change. Oh, I need to do it here. Here we go. Halo line one. We need to, oh no, that's what I wanted. We need to change this. Let's set it to not auto replace. And Halo line 2, same thing. We want you 100% and don't auto replace. All right, cool. Oh man, how much are our passenger, how much are they making? The thing is, when they auto replace, it takes a while for them to get back up to max. But I'm guessing they're going to be making fair old money. Oh, we still didn't look. Man, I suck. We still need to look and see what speeds these are getting up to. You're doing 46. Oh, you're doing 60. Oh, now he's having to slow down through this road section. See, that needs to be changed. That needs to be changed probably into a tunnel. Let's check the one that was going in the opposite direction. Oh, here you go. 56. Yeah, so he's only... I mean, there's not really any point putting faster trains in. Yeah, maybe... I don't know. Where's kind of a long, straightish kind of run? Probably, I don't know, maybe down here is a fairly straightish kind of run. Let's have a look. Oh, that's a freight train. What speed are you going? He's doing 60. So the Mallard should beat that, surely. Yes, it will, and stop calling me Shirley. Here we go. What speeds are you doing? Okay, you're up to 59, 60. It got up to 67. Alrighty. But I don't know. Like, I wonder, if we upgraded to high-speed tracks, would it make a difference? Would that make a difference? I don't know. That's a very good point. I'll tell you what we could do. We could test it out by upgrading the section that guy just came in on, because we know he got up to 60. Right, let's do it. Let's have a bit of a test. So let's upgrade high speed tracks. Let's see, here we go, high speed tracks. All right, so we want to upgrade there and this station is now all high speed. So let's follow a Mallard coming down here and see what speed you get. So here we go. Nope, that's a freight train. Where's the next Mallard? Here we go, here's the next Mallard. So he's just coming into Bickety's Hollow. Oh, it's the Mr. Mackenzie. Cool. Here we go. Oh, he's doing 72. 73. 74. Oh, man, he's flying. Oh, now that's how a Mallard should look. Overtaking a slow freight train. Flying down here, 80 miles an hour. And I like the fact that you can see which is high speed and which is normal. Is he going to reach max? I think he is, you know. 85. Well, this is going to improve our throughput. And that's going to improve our profits. Oh, we almost got up to max. Now, let's see. Yeah, these trains are a little bit long for these stations. Like, yeah, a little bit. Little bit too long. Let's have a look at this. I don't think... Yeah, I didn't upgrade... Ah, that's it. This is one of the stations that I didn't upgrade. And I should. You know what? Let's pause. Do I upgrade this station? I should probably do it offline. I don't know why I didn't upgrade that station. If we go around to the next one, which is Dawlish over here. Now, this one I did upgrade. And you can see that these trains actually fit on here. Let's see. And now... Oh, how many passengers are we going to get? And we're going to get the full, well, almost the full complement. 181 out of 210. Let's have a look over here. You got some fairly big queues going on over here. Let's have a look. Halo Line 1. Is this a Halo Line 1 train? Yes, it is. Now, let's see if this gets a full load of passengers. Because it should do. If it doesn't, then it's because the train's too long. So, here we go. If it gets stuck at, like, what was it, 181? They take time to load up, don't they? When you got this many passengers. Yeah, full load of passengers, so no, that's fine. With the, I just need to go and upgrade that other station, I think. All right, cool. Let's check out the profit situation. We made 58 million last year. And let's see, did we have any? Yeah, we spent 12 million on, so that's 70 million. Okay. All right. Let's have a look at our lines. See how we're doing. Change it by name. Go up to the top. So, oh my God, they're making 35 million a piece. The Halo lines again. Wow. I wonder what that's going to max out at, because they're still not up to full capacity. So that's going to be... that's going to be very interesting to see. Let's flip that around and check out Halo Freight 1 and 2. Now, these things were losing like 5 million a piece, and now they're like way down. I mean, that's only losing like 500,000. That's losing 2. So the situation is definitely better. Okay, you know what? I think we'll leave this episode there, and then between now and the next episode, I will run round and I'll upgrade all of the passenger and freight tracks to high-speed tracks, which I'm sure will make lots of you very happy. And I'll also have a look around and see where we could maybe add more stuff onto the freight lines. So, like, I don't know. We've already added the brick. Let's go and check our brick line. How's our brick line doing? What are you producing now? You're up to 150. So, yeah, that's helping. Let's go and check our steel mill. You know what I should do? I should just go to here. It's so much easier. No, that's towns, you bonehead. Right, here we go. Flip this upside down. There we go. So, let's see. Was doing well. Where's the steel mill? That's the sawmill. Sawmill's doing producing 300 at the moment. Here's the steel mill, the Ghoul steel mill. Oh, it's doing 200. And the limit's gone up to 4. Peachy. And the iron mine and the coal mine, which is supplying that, are both at their limit of 200. So those should upgrade to 400 pretty soon. So yeah, I think we've finally solved those problems, which means, we're producing some slag. Oh hooray! What are you guys carrying now? Let's have a look. Oh my God, you're up to actually carrying 32. You're carrying 36. Wow. My God, those might actually start turning a profit if we're not careful. How are we doing over here? My God, this is producing some food. We definitely need to get the upgraded cars on here. We're not carrying enough food around. We need more freight trains. We need more freight trains. We need more passenger trains. We need more of everything. So if you want to see more of everything, come back for the next one. Oh, last thing. There's always one more thing that I want to check. I just want to look and see how our airplanes are doing. Ah, well, we've got passengers on an ice cream line. So that they obviously can get passengers. They're just not getting them. They can get them, but they're not getting them. I don't know why. No idea. All right, guys, I will catch you for the next one. If you're not loving this, there's something seriously wrong with you. Leave me comments. I want to know more things that I've done wrong. Maybe things that I've done right. I know it's unlikely. And what else you want to see, what else you want me to do. I'll catch you for the next one. Peace out.